sunshine, you know how I feel. Never run to fight, you know how I feel. Love, freedom is mine, and I know how I feel. It's a new dawn, it's a new day, it's a new life for me. And I'm feeling good. Oh, it's so good. Okay, so a song that I really never perform anymore because the girl doesn't have a memory anymore. So I brought the music just in case, then I decided to do it. And I'm going to put my glasses on, just ignore that I'm wearing my glasses as a performer. For those that don't know, a long, long time ago, I was a performer. How long ago was it? Oh, ages, Jesus. But the reality is, I'm a working musician. I'm a working musician. I love music. I always have. I was one of those kids, I was born singing. It just came natural to me. I was very fortunate. I had family that liked to sing, and people got that I liked singing too. And they nurtured me. And whenever we'd have dinner and it was time to clean up, my parents would say, "You go play the piano and sing to us." Play it! I mean, that was my life. And it was always just something, this lovely gift that I was given. And when, as my parents progressed in life and we moved to a better school, and all of a sudden, I had music. I was 13, and I had music once a week for 30 minutes. Very exciting part of my life. And you could join choir as an afternoon club. I think it was a Wednesdays. And you got to sing with the kids in high school. If you auditioned and you got in, you got to sing with the kids in high school. And the first... Thanks, Kev. And the first piece, classical piece that we did, was Mozart's Laudate Domino. People who have been with the choirs for a long time will know the piece. And I never forgot it. I couldn't believe that I heard this fantastic piece of music. And not that I had been a stranger to classical music. I probably heard it but didn't know. I was raised in an Italian-American, and pretty much I was raised on Sinatra, a little Louis Prima, Dean Martin in the mix, with some Judy Garvin. But Sinatra was played every Sunday in the house. He was like a god, just so you know. And all of a sudden, in this music program and singing in a choir, and my world opened up. And one time I was singing, and my teacher, he was English, music teacher, his name was Cecil C. Cross.
Well, we call Cecil.
Okay. One American calls Mr. Cross. And Mr. Cross walked by me, and I was singing, and he said, when you're given a gift, you share your gift. Now, I know, I mean, it just made such a profound, I'm getting emotional. It made such an impact on me in my life. And because singing is such a great thing. You don't have to be great at it. You know, I'm lucky, I'm blessed. I was born with a voice, I can sing operatic, I can sing all kinds of things. But when I see everybody singing together, the joy and the faces that you guys don't get to see, that I get to see because I'm in front of you, there's nothing like it. You give me this gift that I get to receive. And that's why I say, I don't care if you squeak and squawk. I want you to enjoy the moment of singing, what it does to us as a group of people. And that's what it's all about for me. I want you to experience everything, all kinds of sounds, all kinds of music, because it's all a groove. We all will have our preferences and the things we like, but it's a great thing. When we breathe together and we make sound together, it's terrific. Anyway. choir's parties next Tuesday, you can go. Okay? And then Hastings will be on March 1st. Brighton had theirs last week. Anyway, this song that I never perform anymore, but I copied the music, Ginny, and I bought it, okay? And it's used to be a favorite for me to perform, and it's called Desperado. Oh. Yes, Jimmy. Yes, I actually copied that out too. Let me put my glasses back on.